How are you? How are you doing?
She's coming for you, Billy.
Oh, yeah, right, yeah.
She got her eye on Paddy.
Oh, that's not a coin there.
Hello, Father.
Are we getting the eye from all the gaitles on?
I hope you don't get into any mischief.
Oh, you know us, Father.
I do. And that's the trouble.
lads.
Sorry, I have to go. The competition starts any second.
Father, that's not on, impersonating some Bob. And what would all those other Live Aid people think? Peter Gabriel and Queen and the other bands that went on earlier in the day. And what about Phil Collins flying all the way to Boston?
Oh, Satan! Shoddy workmanship, that's what it is. Shoddy! Ted, for crying out loud, will you get up there? The girls won't stay lovely forever, you know.
Sorry, Father Jack just punched me in the stomach. God.
Hello, lovely girls. Look at them there. Walking around.
Mrs. Doyle. Someone at the door, Mrs. Doyle. Mrs. Doyle!
Hello there.
Well, Imelda, you're a lovely girl. Although I hear you had a bit of bad luck recently. Your dog was knocked down by a car and killed.
No, that was my father.
It says here that you're 22.
19.
Right, and you were born in Mayo. That's a lovely part of the world.
Dundalk.
Dundalk, yeah. And it says here that you're a black belt in karate now. So what would you do if I came at you like that? Ah! I'm Elder! All right. I tell you what, you look through my notes and stop at any point of information that's actually true.
I will indeed, Father. You haven't told me your name yet, Father.
Em. Be yourself. Right. Father Dougal Maguire.
All right. This is a great house. I really love the crude religious imagery. Yes, I like it.
Are you all right there? How's your bra?
What?
Your bra. Is it comfortable? Do you have a bra? It's not too tight, is it? Because you can loosen it if you want. Take it off, sure. Go on. Or would you like some tea? I'll tell you what. I'll make the tea and you take your bra off.
Oh, wait. Isn't that Bob Geldof there?
No, is it? Wait a second. It is, you know. He's looking a bit rough.
I should have lost all his money in that Live Aid thing.
I'm not sure if it is Bob Geldof. Hang on there a second. Excuse me, are you...
Back off!
He's himself, all right.
And now, walking. Oh. Look at them there, walking around. Look out there, Mary. Doesn't Mary have a lovely bottom?
Careful there, Ted. That might offend the girls.
Rightly. Of course. They all have lovely bottoms.
Actually, Mrs. Doyle is the one who makes the tea and she's out.
Why don't you just make the tea?
But Mrs. Doyle makes the tea.
Anyway, I'd better just tell you the reason I'm here. I'm looking for a house around the area and I really, really like this one.
I'm sorry, Joan. Your sandwich exceeds the required 6 centimetres in width, and that means it's between Imelda and Mary in the lovely laugh tiebreak. In order to hear your lovely laugh, I'll have to tell you a joke. So here we go. This is my Robin Williams impression. Okay, here we go. This is the joke now, okay? Secretary. Sir, the invisible man is in reception. Got that? Boss, tell him I can't see him. I think I have to say Imelda's laugh is nicer. I'm sorry, Mary. That means Imelda is the winner. And there's your certificate of loveliness. And of course, you'll be going to dinner tomorrow in Craggy Island's top seafood restaurant, the Thai Cottage. And who will you be inviting to dinner?
I'll be bringing my mother.
Just have another go at that, Imelda.
Oh, yes, I'll be inviting you,
Father. Yes, you will! And you'll be paying. It's not me who pays. So there she is, the winner of our lovely girl 1996. It's Imelda!
Well, there you are, Ted. How did the lovely girls' competition go?
Brilliantly well, and as is the tradition, I get a free dinner tomorrow night.
Great. Is Jack with you?
Oh, God, Jack.
Wow. You really knocked Michael Hutchins unconscious.
I battered him!
Anyway, anything happened while I was away?
Nope, can't think of anything anyway. Oh, your one Niamh Connolly called.
Niamh Connolly? What did you say to her?
Oh, don't worry, Ted. It was fine. I just took your advice about talking to girls and it was grand. She's upstairs now.
She's still here?
Yeah, actually, I think she's in the toilet. Oh, hello again. I was just telling Ted you were in the toilet.
Hello there. Father Ted Crilly. You must be Miss Connolly. Oh, I suppose that's sexist now, to call a young lady miss. I'm sorry, it's too late for me to change my ways. You can't teach an old dog new tricks.
Well, it's getting kind of late.
All right, well, I won't keep you. Bye, Saul.
Bye. Goodbye, Father.
Yes, goodbye.
Oh, Ted, that's the other thing. I sold Niamh the house.
What?
Actually, I just gave it to her.
What? You... Wait a minute.
Niamh's going to turn it into a studio. She said we can have all the recording time we want.
Wait now. You gave her the house. I mean, how...
Ted, wait a second. Where are we going to live?
Miss Connolly, there's been a terrible misunderstanding here.
Look, I have to record a duet over the phone with Peter Gabriel, so I hope you don't mind, but Nigel and Tony will show you out.
Well, I'm sorry, but we're not going anywhere.
Oh?
Right. I'm not staying here to be insulted by you. Come on, Dougal, we're leaving. I wouldn't stay in this house if you gave me £1 million. Wait a minute. What did I say there? I meant to say, please give us back the house. What did I say? Why are we outside?
Ted, where are we going to live?
God almighty, Dougal. I go away for a few hours and you've managed to give away the house. I mean, take me through it again. What exactly happened?
I was just sticking to your rules, Ted. Number one, be yourself.
No. Be yourself is just something people say. Never be yourself with women. Never, never, never. What then?
Well, I tried to make her more comfortable, like you said.
Yes.
So I asked her to take off her bra.
We'll come back to that one. But you gave away the house.
What about the golden rule, Ted? Always give them what they want.
No. That's the silver rule. The golden rule is if anyone is ever talking to you again, think about what you're saying and then don't say it and then just run away somewhere. Right? All right. This is a long shot, but it's our only hope. I'm going to leave this paper and pencil here, and hopefully in the morning God will have written down what we should do, okay?
That is a long shot.
It's our only hope, Dougal. Come on, God,